In this session, we will continue with the study of hormone receptors. In the previous session, we studied the surface receptors, and here we are going to study the intracellular receptors. Now, the objective, learning objective of this chapter are to study the intracellular hormone receptors and to understand the molecular nature of these hormones, hormone receptors. And at the end of the session, the student will be able to discuss the intracellular hormone receptors and learn about the molecular nature of the receptors, which is understood. Now, the surface receptors are associated with the protein hormones, whereas the intracellular receptors, hormone receptors, they are for the steroid hormones. Now, the steroid hormones, which include vitamin D and the hormones secreted by adrenal cortex and the gonads, they are derived from the cholesterol. They are actually lipid hormones. So, such lipid hormones have intracellular receptors. They have the receptors inside the cell of the target organs. And other group of hormones are those derived either from tyrosine or from the tryptophan, like thyroid hormones. So, the steroid hormones and the thyroid hormones have their receptors intracellularly. The receptors for steroid and thyroid hormones are located inside the cell, as I already mentioned. These receptors are soluble proteins which function through gene activation. Now, here, these receptors are very special because they are directly involved in the gene activation. They directly interact with the DNA molecule. Now, they are classified according to their location inside the cell, and they target specific sequence of a DNA. Now, we know that specific part of the DNA will be having a specific gene, which is associated with the specific function of the hormone, the steroid hormone. So, in this way, the steroid hormones will enter inside the cell and they will bind with the intracellular receptors. The intracellular receptor will target a specific part of the DNA containing a specific gene, and that gene will be activated. So, this is how the intracellular receptors function. Now, intracellular receptors are a family of ligand-regulated transcription factors. So, they are nothing but transcription factors because they have to work with DNA molecules and they have to work in the gene expression. And they are activated by the steroid hormones. Now, these transcription factors cannot act on their own. They are not activated previously. So, they will function only after binding with a specific steroid hormone. And they are also lipid soluble. They are also stimulated by the lipid soluble signals. Now, intracellular receptors are proteins that share considerable amino acid sequence similarity in two highly conserved domains. That means, we find so many different types of intracellular receptors in different cells, but all these intracellular receptors share conserved sequences of amino acids. We find this conserved sequence of amino acids in two domains. That is, one is DNA binding domain, the part of the receptor which binds to the DNA molecule, and ligand binding domain, the part of the receptor which binds to the ligand, nothing but the hormone. Hormone receptors are grouped into different classes. Here we'll discuss only important classes. So steroid receptor family. So one family of intracellular hormone receptor is steroid receptor. They predominantly exist in cytoplasm. They are bound to heat shock proteins. And steroid receptor family of intracellular hormone receptors include the receptors of estrogen hormone, androgen hormone, progesterone, mineralocorticoid, and glucocorticoid. So estrogen, androgen, progesterone are the hormones secreted by the gonads, and mineralocorticoid and glucocorticoid are the hormones secreted by the adrenal gland. And the target organs of these hormones, they exist throughout the body, and the target organs are controlled by these hormones via the intracellular hormone receptors. And another class of receptor family includes the receptor for thyroid hormones. We know that the thyroxine hormone will affect the metabolic activity of almost all part of the body. Then retinoic acid, which is associated with vitamin A and vitamin D. And the basic components of intracellular receptors are zinc fingers, heat shock proteins, co-activator and co-repressor, and a hormone response element. So the intracellular receptors, basically they are made up of these important parts: zinc fingers, heat shock proteins, co-activator and co-repressor, and a hormone response element. And here is a list of some important intracellular receptors. It's just a list. Androgen receptors for androgen hormones, calcitriol receptors, corticotropin releasing hormone receptor 1 and receptor 2, estrogen receptors, follicle stimulating hormone receptors, glucagon receptors, gonadotropin receptors, gonadotropin releasing hormone receptors, which are found in the pituitary gland cells, growth hormone receptors, which are found in most part of the body cells, insulin receptors, luteinizing hormone receptors, progesterone receptors, retinoid receptors, somatostatin receptors, thyroid hormone receptors, thyrotropin receptors. So these are some of the important intracellular receptors found in many cells of the body. Now, to summarize this session, intracellular receptors are the molecules which are present inside the cell, and they are activated by the steroid hormones. So in the next we have multiple choice questions. The students are advised to attend the multiple choice questions. Thank you.